So one of the questions that came in is, okay, so there's all these issues that have to get taken care of, but like what actually happens? How do companies actually train their employees to do this shift from commercial over to GCC high? Because it's not like you just wake up one day and then you're in there, right? There are some issues that you got to be aware of.
I mean, you're looking at things like re-enrolling mobile devices, right? Doing that, potentially re-enrolling computers if they're direct join with Intune into intra-ID joins. You're looking at resetting up guest accounts, right? So when you go to the GovCloud, we just talked about B2B. Now you might need, in order to have that same capability, to build a trust between your partner tenants and your own tenant, right? So you can collaborate on those documents again. Well, there's another gotcha there, right? Because now you need to make sure with your supply chain team, are the people who are actually allowing to collaborate accepted the DFARS 7012 flow down, right? So there's some policy work that has to be done and procedure work that has to be done to make sure that your, what we call visitor management components of guest users are checking the box appropriately. You're looking at simple things like setting up Outlook, resetting up Teams, resyncing OneDrive and SharePoint libraries. And then some seamless things that should happen in the background are configuration of their single sign-on applications, right? So that should be done by IT, just pointing them to the new location for intra-ID in the GovCloud. But again, you start peeling this back. I mean, it could easily take a user, you know, 1 to 3 hours to kind of get reset back up into a stable state so they can continue to work. Now, luckily, there's some good things with like hybrid join. That's an easy move versus a direct join, that the user is kind of transparent to even knowing anything happened. But yeah, I mean, there's several things they need to know around what do I need to set up day one? And then the one thing that's most impactful for people going to GCC High is my external users now have to open a Teams meeting in a web browser because the Teams thick client app doesn't typically join. And my guest users, I have to go ahead and set up a trust between them, which you can do proactively, which IT has to do. External Microsoft forms no longer work. So you can use internal Microsoft forms, but externals don't work. So if you have forms for intake, things like that, for like onboarding a new vendor or a new employee that don't yet have a named account inside of your environment, that you'll have to look to substitute that to like a SurveyMonkey or, you know, some kind of tool of that nature. So yeah, there are definitely several kind of significant changes. My recommendation after going through this a lot, communicate consistently, do lunch and learns, do video recordings, publish them out. If you have like a know before instance, you can upload and validate to some extent that they've watched those things. That would be ideal. But you know, users will be users, and come day of, chances are a good significant portion of them will have not read what they need to read in order to be prepared. So also just have a good support team and kind of a, you know, a go live hotline they can call, right, when something does happen, or help, I can't log in, or, you know, things like that. So there's a lot of nuances to all that. That's just kind of broad stroke kind of what to expect when expecting, at least on the user side. But it's a lot of organizational change management, a lot of education.